This video, I'd like to show you how to calculate the weight of a B in the composition of A1 and A2 in both the real and the tropical semi-ring. Maybe you remember what composition E means. That is, if you have two transducers. In this case, you want to put in A into A1. Then you get anything out. You will use this output as input for A2 and you will get out B. And from this we want to have the weight. And as always, the main thing you want to remember from this video is how to properly use this definition, because it tells you everything that you need about how to retrieve the weight of this composition. Now let's have a look. Here we have the it says we want to retrieve the weight of the composition of those transducers, where the input is W and the output is V. And when you look now here it says we want to input W into transducer 1 and we will get U out, which is not mentioned here. And we will use U as input for the second transducer. And then we want to multiply both rates and we want to sum up about all over all possible U's. So in this case, U is anything that's possible. So in this case, our alphabet contains A and B. So in this case, well, the things you could get out with an A is A or B. So that's what we are using for U. And we want to sum up over this. Now let's start with retrieving the first weight. As before, I will write down the calculation for the real semi-ring in the upper part and for the tropical semi-ring in the lower part. So, and for the first weight, maybe let's use another color. For my first weight, U will be A, and for the second weight, I need my U will be B, because that's everything that's defined as output for A1 when I input A. So, the first weight we need is the weight when we put in A and we get U out, in this case A. So, for our first transducer, this corresponds to this weight, so it's 0.5, and I also need the same weight later for my tropical semi-ring. Then we want to retrieve the second weight, where we put in A into the second transducer and getting B out. In this case, that belongs to that weight, so we need here we need our 3.5, and then I already know I need later the same for B. So let's retrieve the weights for B first. So in this case, in the first automaton, when I want to put in A, I want to get out B. So this corresponds to this weight, 1.3. And then for the second weight, we want from the second automaton where we put in our U, which is now B, and we want to get B out. This corresponds to weight 0.2. Now we have all the weights that we need. Now we want to multiply about the weights where the U's, where we use the same U. So in this case, we have to look up what our multiplication is. So in our abstract semi-ring, which is used for the definition, the multiplication is at the third position. For the real semi-ring, this is the multiplication. So that means I want to do the multiplication between those weights. And for the tropical semi-ring, the multiplication is the addition. So I want to add those weights to each other. So then I want to sum up over all possible U's. Then I need another color for that. I want to sum up over all possible use. I need to retrieve what our addition is. In the real Semi-Ring, this is our plus. So I'm writing a big plus over those between those weights. And for the tropical Semi-Ring, our plus is the minimum. So I want to perform, I want to find the minimum of both of those weights. And then the last thing I have to do is just plain calculation. So that means when I multiply this and I add those other multiplication for the first line, well, I, of course, I did it in advance. I don't want to show you math here. So this for the first line, I'm getting a weight of 2.01 in the real semi-ring for those composition. And for the tropical semi-ring, well, if you add this to each other, you get 4. If you add this to each other, you get 1.5. And the minimum of both is 1.5. And this is the weight of the composition in this tropical semi-ring. And now I'm done with both tasks.